The big story tonight really has been the impact of Arun Jaitley's budget, and one of the big takeaways of that budget was the announcement that donations to political parties in cash are being brought down from 20,000 rupees per individual to 2,000 rupees, which means now no more than 2,000 rupees in cash can be donated to political parties. But there continues to be a big loophole in that, which is that those donations of 2,000 rupees in cash can still be anonymous. So the parties do not have to disclose who these donors are. And that, experts and analysts say, is something that could continue to create a system of opaqueness in the electoral system. Let's take a look at what the Association for Democratic Reforms had actually said on the sources of funds of political parties. And this is a recent report that they just brought out, saying that 69% of funds of political parties are from unknown sources. That if you look at the individual party breakup, 94% of funds of the Samajwadi Party, for instance, are from unknown sources. 86% of funds of the Akali Dal from unknown sources. 83% of funds of the Congress Party come from unknown sources. Similarly, for the BJP, 65% of their funds are from unknown sources. So is this move by the government actually going to be enough to further political reforms and bring out transparency in the system, or is there a lot more that needs to be done? We have Kamini Jaiswal, senior Supreme Court lawyer and member of the Association for Democratic Reforms, joining us tonight. Mr. T.H. Krishnamurthy, the former Chief Election Commissioner of India, is with us. Sambit Patra, spokesperson of the BJP. Mr. Shailesh Gandhi, former Central Information Commissioner. And we have Ajoy Kumar, spokesperson of the Congress. Preeti Menon, spokesperson of the AAP. As well. Mr. Krishnamurthy, let me ask you first, sir. Do you welcome this move, the finance minister's announcement, and do you believe it goes far enough? All right, I apologize there. I'm sorry, Mr. Krishnamurthy, sir, we can't hear you. Mr. Gandhi, let me ask you that question. What do you think of this particular announcement? Do you think it's a good start? Does it do enough?
I don't think it does enough, and a very simple solution is available, because in terms of 2,000 rupees, you can just claim that I have so many more people, even if names of recipients are to put down. All it requires is putting down 10 times more recipients. So that doesn't help any. But today the government itself is claiming that over 90%, or is it 99%, of citizens have Aadhaar cards. Why not a very simple thing saying all donations will be linked to an Aadhaar card number? And a simple software could figure out if the same Aadhaar card number was being used multiple times. This is an extremely simple solution. If the government does this, they would actually reduce a lot of black money getting into the elections and getting into the political system. Also, one other thing is right to information. Six parties have been declared as being under right to information illegally, without any legal basis. They are defying the law. Why don't at least one of the political parties, BJP, Congress, SP, whichever, say they will have all their donations linked to Aadhaar card numbers and ensure that they become completely transparent by following the RTI. If they do this, this would be a major change and a great gain, say, for the whole nation, if they think of the nation.
And so you believe that parties will continue to basically find loopholes even though the cash donation amount has come down. They'll find a way around it because it's anonymous, right?
It's obvious that you do not imagine that parties are going to change their ways because of this. I don't see any hope. You have given a big loophole and showing a facade as if you are doing something, whereas actually you are doing nothing.
Sambit Patra, do you want to take on what Mr. Shailesh Gandhi just said, that this doesn't really go far enough to address the issue of the lack of transparency on political funding? If it's not 20,000, it's 2,000, that's fine. But, you know, an anonymous person could make multiple donations of 2,000 and, you know, get away with it.
With all due respect to Mr. Gandhi, I mean, definitely the political funding and the demand for political reforms has been a long-standing issue. I think over decades, the citizens of this country have demanded that there should be a reform as far as political funding is concerned. And in fact, let me take a second to congratulate the government that after all these decades of discussion, finally there is a government which has taken up the path of reforms. Now remember, as far as this decrease from 20,000 to 2,000 is concerned, it's not that the government has made up this whole thing. It is the Election Commission of India, which is an autonomous body, and which after due application of mine, only about a month ago had recommended this to the government, that if you really really want to reform the political funding system, that instead of 20,000 rupees going into anonymity section, it should be 2,000 and below, which should go into the section of anonymity, and that the government has followed what the Election Commission had said. As far as following the digital and the check method of donating money is concerned, look, Nidhi, what is the basic premise of political funding? The basic premise is black money should not be parked in political parties' accounts. That was the major concern. The bearer bond, which Mr. Jaitley had talked about yesterday, that RBI in fact would be authorizing a bank, say any bank of this country, to start bearer bonds. Any person can go to these banks, pay money, white and clean money, because the PAN card has to be submitted and his whereabouts, his name, etc. would be recorded by the bank.
But the donor's name will still remain anonymous even with these bonds. And Sambit, yes, you're right. It was the election commission's suggestion to bring the cash donations down to 2,000 rupees. But in these times when you are asking us to buy toothpaste and vegetables with digital payments, why can't political parties accept all payments that come to them digitally as well? Every single penny. Let it be done through check.
Nidhi, you are absolutely right and your concerns are genuine. I would say that the system has begun, the cleansing process has begun, and gradually it would be extremely stringent in the years to come. Number one, as I told you, and I maintain that since we have one former officer from Election Commission, a very respected one, so I think he would be able to answer as to why the Election Commission, after due application of mine, said that it should be brought down to 2,000. The government has followed the instructions and the recommendations of the Election Commission. I'm sure the Election Commission must have taken everything into account while proposing this recommendation.
Well, Mr. Krishnamurthy, we have you back with us, sir. If you could answer that yeah. Why did the Election Commission come to this formulation of 2,000 rupees? Why not do everything by check and ensure that everyone who donates to a political party, their name, their PAN card, a paper trail is there and it is on record?
Although I was pleasantly surprised that these changes were brought about through the budget speech, I must say that these two measures are not adequate at all. They are only a very, very small step towards the reforms. As far as the Election Commission recommending this, I'm equally surprised that they should have made such a recommendation. They should have said that every donation should bear an identity mark. Why should the concession of 2,000 be given? When we are talking about digital economy and so on, I see no reason why this concession should be given. And as a person who has been in the income tax department, I can tell you that this is going to be misused more than what it was probably under 20,000 rupees. They should reconsider this decision. They must make every donation identifiable. Secondly, as far as the bearer bonds are concerned, I am worried. I am worried that it may be misused, but I have not seen the full details of the scheme. I am unable to comment on it. But the earlier instances of bearer bonds issued have been misused. So we have to be very careful when formulating the scheme for the bearer bonds. But when you say that you have accepted the Election Commission's recommendation, what about other recommendations of the Election Commission? Why have they not been considered? Why should they not be considered now? The urgent need is the electoral reforms if you really want to attack political corruption.
That's a very strongly made point, sir. Sambit, I'll take that back to you before I go to Ajoy and Preeti. Because you were saying that you were only following the instructions of the Election Commission. Mr. Krishnamurthy has been a chief election commissioner. He's saying it was a bad recommendation. Yes. And this is inadequate.
So with all due respect to Mr. Krishnamurthy, whom we all respect extremely, I would say, well, he has the right to criticize the Election Commission and the present Election Commissioner, their colleagues and senior and junior. I, as a spokesperson of a political party, cannot transgress into that domain. And I cannot say that the Election Commission did not apply their mind or applied less of their mind in formulating this kind of recommendation. I can only say that in all earnest, this government followed the recommendation of an autonomous body, and that too of an Election Commission, about which not only the country but the whole world is proud about. As far as the bearer bond is concerned, see, the bearer bond in fact does away with the old system which failed, in which the old system was anyone can donate through a check also, but the people who are donating by check were concerned about the fact that their names would be displayed. Over here, it's not that the names would not be displayed, the name would come to the banking system. The bank would have the name, the PAN number, the details. The most important thing is infusion of clean money, and within a stipulated time period. period. If you have a bearer bond, it's not that during indefinite time period you can go and deposit to the bank. It has to be a stipulated time period within which you have to demand. So what concerns of Mr. Krishnamurthy was, it can be addressed over here.
But second big thing is, why shouldn't the public also know? Ajoy Kumar, you know, it's not just the BJP that should be getting these questions. It's actually all political parties, or most political parties, I should say, that have been very reluctant to undertake electoral reform. I mean, if you look at the ADR numbers, they're rather alarming. The Congress is among the highest in terms of unknown sources of income. We don't know where your money comes from.
Look, Nidhi, if any, all of us in the political space, and I think I agree with Mr. Krishnamurthy, are we guilty of... all of us, you know, any political party, if Sambit comes and says that we are doing a great job by bringing in 2,000, I think it's a joke. And all of us are, so I'm not saying they are bad or we are bad. All of us, Aam Aadmi Party, despite its claims. So the first question, and I want to just focus a couple of things on. One is on the 2,000 rupees is going to be misused, definitely. The other issue on bearer bonds is, the issue was corporate links. If suppose a corporation buys a bearer bond, the issue is how do you link it to the favors which a political party gives it during power or whatever be the relationship? That will never be established because of anonymity. The third part, which is, you know, there is a law which was brought in which said that all MPs, MLAs, all MPs and civil servants would put in their returns of their wife, their family members. That was critically important to see the linkages. Now that is pending. It is the government, this government, it was brought in earlier. This government has been extending it. Sambit can answer it better. Mr. Modi has been saying it, that they are going to change it. The issue was civil servants and the members of parliament and ministers, with their family members, by the way, their sons, their daughters, everybody's assets, because you can then make out, once they come politically, has there been a significant windfall gains once they become a politician? And I'm not pointing fingers at them. I'm pointing fingers at all of us from that perspective. The third part, which, you know, with Mr. Krishnamurthy correctly said, we are focusing on the political funding, which is certain amount of money. We are not focusing at all on political expenditure. The expenditure vis-a-vis the funding is minuscule compared to the expenditure.
What is stopping political parties like yourselves from taking the first step? What stops the Congress from putting all its donors on a website saying, Nidhi, these are the people who donated to us, this is where our source of income is, this is how we're spending it. Do it. You can put it online.
Yeah. So, Nidhi, so I was in an election commission meeting, and one of the suggestions which came up was, during the how to reform the electoral process, one of it was to put, to, you know, that you don't need to put people outside the booth anymore, because the election commission distributes the chits for the the voters to know where is his booth and where is his name in the voting list. No, no party agreed on it. But if you look at any election, conservatively, some party spends 1,000 rupees, some party spends 10,000 rupees per booth. So on the Lok Sabha election, the day of the election, 2,000 booth works out to 2 crore rupees for some. Some may work out to 10 lakhs. The fact is, there has to be an understanding that all political parties have to come and accept it. So these are issues. And once, if no one accepts it, then everybody is scared that he's not going to win this election. And it gets into this rat race where everybody tries to do it. And I'm not saying they are guilty or we are guilty. The fact is, we all have to do it. And
you're
and
saying
just
if it's
don't
not a consensus, it,
it
can't
I'm
be
not
done.
To, you know,
I don't
that,
agree.
Okay, we are cleaner
because,
and he's dirtier, etc.
Because I think individual parties can take a stand. And Preeti, that was the thing about the Aam Aadmi Party, is that it tried to be the party with a difference and actually put up its donations on its website. And now, in the Punjab campaign, for instance, we've seen that that has also stopped, ostensibly because the party says that its donors are being harassed by the IT department. But now we have a lack of transparency, even with the Aam Aadmi Party, on its donations.
There's absolutely no lack of transparency in the Aam Aadmi Party's donation, because we are submitting the entire donor details to the income tax department of every rupee received. 92% of our donations are by check, and the 8% that are by cash are also deposited into the bank, and their entire donor details are submitted to the income tax department. The only reason we've removed it from the website is because of the harassment in the present regime. But coming back to the point of 2,000 rupees.
If it's all being... No, one second, why?
How,
I don't understand why. Because, you know, you're still submitting the details to the IT department, which is also part of the present regime. So why not leave the details on the website also?
When we are... when we're leaving it on the website, our people were feeling vulnerable, the donors were being attacked, and therefore we have chosen to take it down from the website. But it is not that we are not willing to submit it under RTI. It is not that we are not willing to submit it. Into the Income Tax Department, Nidhi, please understand, we submit 100% of our donor details. I would like to correct ADR over here. ADR came up with a report saying that some 50-odd% of Aam Aadmi Party's donations were from unknown sources. That is incorrect. ADR just assumed that all donations about 20,000 are accounted for, and 56% of our donations were below 20,000. But they were not unaccounted for. Against each donation, there is a name and a PAN number. So though our donations are below 20,000 largely, we have accounted for them. We have submitted the details with the Income Tax Department. So all are 1 minute. But let's come back to the 2,000 rupee point, which is more important. It is so glaring. All you had to do earlier was make 1,000 entries to submit 2 crores. Now you have to make 10,000 entries to submit 2 crores. So nothing really changes. Mr. Patra just now said that they will gradually change. But when they did demonetization, they didn't do it gradually. They did it like a whiplash on the country. So why could not they come like a whiplash on political funding? Why could they not do the same thing? They should have immediately ensured that every single political payment is digital. If a bhajiwala is expected to do 20 rupees through digital payments, then why is BJP and Congress not doing everything digitally? We do everything digitally, voluntarily. The second thing is, which we are, I think, kind of missing, the Election Commission has not yet said that payments below 20,000 need to be disclosed. They have not brought it down to 2,000. The Election Commission still says payments up to 20,000 are anonymous.
No, so you're saying that every donation that's
below
given to the AAP,
cash.
You're saying that every donation that's given to the AAP has a PAN number next to it, which is given to the IT department.
Nidhi.
Every single one has a PAN number?
Absolutely. Every single donation of ours is sent with a name,
okay,
the address and the PAN number.
All right, Ajoy Kumar has a quick rebuttal and then I'll take that to Sambit.
Every donor has a receipt.